In 1986, the future was bright indeed for Timbuk3. When their cheerful ode to nuclear destruction, "The Future's So Bright I Gotta Wear Shades," cracked the top 20.
I studied nuclear science. I love my classes.
"The Future's So Bright I Gotta Wear Shades," it wanted to be a bit more sarcastic than it was perceived. I think people took it at face value and thought, this should be my theme song.
I'm doing all right, getting good grades. The future's so bright.
Timbuk3 was husband and wife duo Pat McDonald and Barbara Kay in a boombox. The band was discovered while gigging in Austin, Texas by indie record label IRS. 3 months after signing with the label, Timbuk3 released their debut album.
Heavenly blessed and worldly wise, I'm a peeping Tom techie with x-ray eyes. Things are going great, and they're only getting better.
Things got a lot better. Timbuk3 suddenly found themselves with a hit single, appearances on talk shows and movie soundtracks, and were touring the world with Bob Dylan, Sting, and Jackson Browne, all because of a song most people misinterpreted.
The vision of the future as presented in that song is not a beautiful picture. It's a pretty grim future, presented in a very fun kind of way.
I'm well aware of the world out there, getting blown all to pieces, but what do I care?
But the immediate future was good for Timbuk3. They continued to perform and release records until 1995, when both the band and the marriage split up. Both Pat and Barbara remain committed to making new music. She lives and performs in Austin, Texas, while he resides in Barcelona, Spain.
I've gotta wear shades.